Everybody, welcome to Obrad Reviews, where today I'm going to be doing another first listen type of video. Last time I did the College Dropout, and this time I thought I'd keep the Kanye momentum going a little bit and do the 2018 collaborative record between Kanye and Kid Cudi, Kids See Ghosts. I've heard a lot of good things about this one. I've heard that it's really good. I've seen a lot of 10 out of 10s, 5 out of 5s. So I have really high expectations. This is a project I've really been wanting to listen to for a while now. I just haven't gotten to it. I got the Genius lyrics pulled up here, so I'm going to be following along. You'll catch some of my quick reactions. Once I get like halfway through the project, I'll stop and give some thoughts, and then once I get through the rest, I'll give like a little short review. And if you guys have any suggestions for me, for doing these first listens or for my record reviews, leave them down below. I don't get that many comments, so if you have any suggestions for me, I'll probably do it. There's no limits to my musical tastes: rap, trap, hip-hop, pop, rock, metal, indie, country, anything you want. Hey, leave it down below. I'll be happy to listen to it. Let's get into it. All right, starting us off, we got Feel the Love with Pusha T. Okay, that was an interesting one. I love the beat. We went through multiple different phases there with the beat. I like the kind of the breakdown with all the ba ba ba's, burts, and da da da's. I like that. I like the first verse with Pusha T. Interesting song to kick us off. Kind of short. Not too much writing in here, but it was cool. I liked it. Fire. God, all this pain, I couldn't seem to find a way. On the mission, live it, carry on. Got my family, I'm seeing through by the days. Okay, another short song. I'm noticing a lot of these tracks are pretty short, besides Reborn. Or at least in the beginning here, all these tracks are pretty short here, under 3 minutes. Again, really like the instrumental on this one. It was really nice. I like a lot of the drums in there were really nice. Verses are short here, pretty short, especially for Kanye. Kid Cudi got a little bit of a longer verse. I like what they're saying here. Good writing. Heaven lift me up for all of my wrongs. Okay. Hey, I like it. Fourth Dimension. It feels so good as you come. Brought an alligator. Ooh, that was nasty. He say, like a mix of Master P and Rick Ross. She seen to make me out. That's nasty. That's nasty. What's the cause, boy? Losing everything that I had. She been on me, boy, unless she got something to tell. Sitting waiting for me, slipping, yeah, I see you in hell. Tell the dude to get up, I'll be not my soul for sale. 3 minutes max. Ooh, that sample is nasty. How they did that in the beginning, and then they had it even on the chorus too, but especially right there at the beginning. What is Santa bringing us? And then it rewind back, that it hits those 808s. That drum line was nasty. Those 808s were bumping. They sounded so nice. That drum line that was going on there sounded amazing. I really like the Kid Cudi verse. He came in on that interlude, that creepy, that laughter. That was nasty. I loved it. Free Ghost Town Part 2 with Ty Dolla $ign. It set me free. Another nasty instrumental on this, man. Wow.
nothing hurts me anymore. Guess what, babe? I am.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Best song so far. Best song so far. At least for me, in my opinion, that's the best one. I don't even know what you would call this. I don't even know what you could even... This isn't really even rap. First of all, the drums. Again, amazing. They're using more of like rock and roll style drums, and you can just hear how it's being played. So many other different types of sounds. It's kind of like psychedelic, a little bit of rock, psychedelic, rap, soulful in some parts. It sounds really grand, like it's this cool, like, choir. Also, complex in all of these different sounds that they're using, but also a lot of simplicity in the same time, except, especially in the writing. This is a part two, so I'm missing like a piece here. It says that song's concept is based off of the track Ghost Town, which released 1 week prior on Kanye West's 2018 album Ye. Okay, so I never listened to Ye. So I'm missing the pieces. I don't know if this is really a continuation. I'm missing part one, so I'm not getting the full picture. But part two was really cool. That was like trippy and powerful and grand and really great drums. I'm loving the drums here. I'm loving these drums. The first half, pretty much just straight fire. Straight fire, all gas, no brakes. Reborn.
Party homie was all the tame. All of you Mario, it's all the game. I'm sorry.
This thing about Kanye, man, he just has something to say. He just has something to say on his verses. You hear so much just recycled garbage. Eternal Take is a big example for me. Everybody waited so long for Uzi to drop this big project, and it just turned out to just be this generic 5 out of 10, just recycled album. Just recycled ideas, generic beats, boring verses. This guy's got something to say. He knows how to write a verse. He's got stuff that he wants to say. Even on Cudi's verse there at the end, I mean, again, he's got something to say. Easy feel worthless. We're looking for my purpose. I guess, the point of the song here is they're just kind of coming to terms with themselves and they want to be better, improve themselves, get over their issues. For me, though, it's kind of starting to run out of steam here at the end with the chorus and the bridge and then the chorus again. Yeah, it kind of, like, devolves into this more spacey kind of vibe, and it kind of breaks down a little bit, but I don't know. I think this chorus really just overstayed. I like the chorus, but I think it's kind of overstaying its welcome a little bit for me here. Cool, I'm excited for this one. Title track, Kids See Ghosts. I like it already. I like it already.
Clever enough to give up while I'm ahead. I like breakfast in bed, but I love breakfast ahead. For anybody who said that I was better off dead, told them don't ever leave nothing that you ever read. Got a Bible by my bed, oh yes, I'm very Christian. Constantly.
Okay. Really like the beat on that one. I had a really creepy vibe. I think this song really did a good job of creating a really nice atmosphere. It definitely had an air to it. Especially with Cudi's verse. He sounded really like dead, like lethargic, and it really went along. I don't know what that top melody is, that ding, 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 whatever that is. I don't know what that is, but it really kind of lifted the track up a little bit with the nice drums that were going on there. The bridge here with Yasin, talking about civilization without society, power and wealth with nobility. Stability without stasis, places and spaces. Was really interesting. I'm trying to figure out what this song is really about. So, I don't know. It seems like there's some philosophical elements to it. But I think it looks like it goes a little bit deeper than it seems. So, I don't know. I'm not sure. Cudi montage.
Supposed to be in there looking out nowhere. Where's all money hidden there?
Pain in my eyes and the time I find I'm stumbling in the ever woods. If we could again, God, shine your love on me. Save me, please.
Everybody want world peace till your knees get shot in the dome piece. Then you're going by your own peace, hoping it'll help you find your own peace.
Ooh. Everybody want world peace till your knees get shot in the dome piece, and you're going by your own peace, hoping it'll help you find your own peace. Ooh, that's nasty. Yeah. Yeah. Again, Cudi montage. Great song. Amazing writing again. These guys have shit to say. That's why Kanye is where he's at. That's why Kid See Ghost got as much attention as it did. You know why? Because they have something to say. At least for me, that's what I think. Because there's only so many songs that people are going to want to listen to where you just want to talk about having money, doing drugs, and having girls. I mean, there's only so much of that we can take. You know why people want to listen to Kid See Ghost? You know why people want to listen to these songs? Because they got something that they want to say. And they can articulate it and translate it well. This is a really interesting project. One of my biggest complaints is that it's just not long enough. A lot of these, the instrumentals are amazing. Interesting sounds, cool patterns. Nice samples. The Kurt Cobain sample on Cudi montage was awesome. And a lot of this I really did like. For me, I don't know. Some of these tracks I think I'd have to dive into a little bit deeper. I'm definitely feeling at least an 8.5. Because this album is a vibe. And it is interesting. This is definitely a fun listen. Fun, short listen. We got one half with straight fire, other half a little bit more slowed down, more vibey. Really interesting project. I'm glad I listened to it. At least an 8.5. I hope, this was 2018. I don't know if Kid See Ghost is planning to do anything else. I sure hope so. I'd like to see a much bigger, longer, fuller, grander project from these guys. It would probably sound amazing. That's going to do it for this video. If you have any suggestions, like I said, hey, put them down below. I'll probably do it. If you like this video, give me a like. If you hated it, give me a dislike. I'll catch you guys on the next one.